Hey everybody, my name is Matt Sokup, and welcome to the first of a series of providing authentication to Xamarin apps with Azure's Active Directory B2C offering. So the first part in this series obviously would be creating the Active Directory tenant through the Azure portal. So what you need to do first is open up the Azure portal. If by chance you don't have an account, you can always go to azure.microsoft.com/free to sign up for a free account so you can proceed with the next steps. So once you have that done, you can go back into the Azure portal and then create the new B2C tenant. There's a tricky part to this though. Normally, you can go into something like App Services and then click Add. However, you can't do that with a plain old Azure Active Directory, or if you do search for B2C, there's no Add button here either. What you need to do is actually hit the New button all the way up on top, then search the marketplace for B2C. Select the Azure Active Directory B2C option, and you'll be presented with this blade. Hit the Create button, and then select this option. Create a new Azure AD B2C tenant. You'll then be presented with a couple options. So you can go on and create a new organization name, a domain name, and then select a country or region. The directory creation will take about a minute, so once you hit the Create button, be prepared to wait a bit. So once it's finished, you'll get this click here to manage your new Active Directory. Click on it and a new tab opens. So you have now transported into the new Azure AD B2C directory. So you think everything's ready to go, but you get this warning message, no subscription length. So this part is what messed me up for a little bit. So I click on it and you get these directions of what to do. Switch directories to the location of your target Azure subscription, marketplace, search and select for B2C, select create. That didn't make a lot of sense to me when I was doing it. So what you have to do is flip back to the other tab, then select this option right below it. Let this part load up. And then when it's finished, you can select the dropdown, and then the AD tenant that you just created will show up. Select it, know which subscription you're putting it in, and then you can either create a new resource group or use an existing one. Determine where you want to put it, and then create it. Then once all of that is finished, you'll get the overview page. By clicking on this card below, you'll be able to open up another tab, which brings you back into the new tenant. There is another way you can get into the new Active Directory tenant, and that's by selecting your email address. You can see the one that we just created now is showing up underneath the directory. Click on it, and then we're brought right into it again. So once we're there, we can start doing things such as creating new applications. And that's what we'll talk about in the next video in this series, adding authentication to a Xamarin app so it can talk to a REST API using Azure AD B2C.